was going to sew his thing around.
Jared, can you believe that it's already been a month and a half since we've been back from Israel?
Can't. I feel like the impact of the trip really took a while to sink in, just because when you're there, it's so overwhelming to be standing in these sights, and so it's almost like you can't process it. You're trying to take notes and take pictures and take mental pictures, and then it takes about a month and a half when you get back to actually have it all sink in. I was in Israel, I was in these sights.
Even now, I'm just starting to realize how much God used that trip in my life, you know? I just remember walking into the city of Capernaum. There's just a little sign there, and it says Capernaum, the town of Jesus, or something like that. And just the sensation of walking through that gateway, like I am now in the city where Jesus did, you know, live during his ministry. We were in the synagogue that he taught at, and then walking down the street, and there's Peter's house. Yeah. Like literally, that's the Apostle Peter's house. So, I mean, if you get to go, I mean, it would blow your mind.
And the whole trip was interesting because we would go back and forth between New Testament and Old Testament sites. So right around the time we went to Capernaum, we also went to Shiloh, where the tabernacle was for several hundred years, where Hannah went and prayed for a son, where Samuel went and served Eli, and then eventually served as the high priest, where the Ark of the Covenant was. And so to see this flat spot where the tabernacle was, it was just unbelievable. And, you know, I mean, you're seeing things from the life of Christ, you're seeing things from the life of Israel. And so to be thinking of that narrative and to see it all unfolding before you right there was incredible. I mean, were there places like that for you?
Yeah, I mean, my first thought is Masada, you know, and here we are basically in this desert wilderness area, which was the same area that David hid out from Saul.
And if you remember being up there, you could see the whole Dead Sea area.
Yeah.
And Dr. Bookman referred to it as a moonscape, because that's what it is. I mean, it just these, nothing grows there at all. And that was the area in which Christ was tempted. And so to be able to think about just how desolate a place it was, you know, not only did he not have food or water, but he was all alone, but he was in the most desolate of places, I mean, the lowest place on the planet.
You know? Yeah. So, you guys, obviously I haven't been yet. I'm really looking, hopefully able to go sometime soon. So tell me, you guys went Sermon on the Mount, right?
Yeah.
So what did that look like?
To picture it, I mean, because we were up on top, and so you can picture Christ, you know, speaking down to the crowds. Yeah, that was unbelievable. And just how close it is to Jerusalem. I mean, you know, a lot of the things that he's saying really relate to the temple, right? And so as he's standing there saying these things, he's looking almost eye level with the Temple Mount.
Man, Jerusalem, the one thing about Jerusalem is once you show up there, it's like this overwhelming sense of the most important city in known to mankind, because it's the city that God chose to have his name dwell. You get there and you're looking at the Temple Mount. The bottom walls to the walls of the temple were the ones that Herod built during Jesus' day.
And they're still there.
Yeah. And we went up and touched them.
Yeah.
You know, and we actually followed along underneath the Muslim houses and followed along the walls.
And then to go up on the Temple Mount structure, it's so vast. It's so much bigger than we can picture. I mean, just to think about all the things that happened there, all the times Christ taught there. It's just unbelievable.
It really wasn't much. It really wasn't the fact that you were there on a physical place. It was more relating the word and where Jesus was, where things were compared. Yeah.
And that's one of my favorite parts that we did is for some sites, we would stop and read the biblical narrative. It really does root it in geography and history.
Yeah.
So that when you're reading any portion of scripture, whether it's Old Testament narrative or the Psalms or the New Testament or even Pauline literature, you just have an awareness of the scenery that they're describing.
Yeah.
You know, you get to see where David tended his sheep. You get to see where Israel fought some of their battles. You get to see where Christ talked to Peter in John 21. You get to see all those sites. So it changes the way that you read scripture.
I'm really thankful for being able to go on the trip and Shepherd's commitment to getting their students over to Israel. Next time the trip comes around, I mean, I'd love to go, and I'm excited for the opportunity that'll have too.
As they say at Passover, next time in Jerusalem. Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
We'll be there.
That's right.